bottle at one point, we would like also to detail, explore different structures on the surface. Currently, this design is solid, so this is actually really good. I want to keep it actually this way. I will round this bottom part one more time, and then for the moment, hide this. And now I can think about how I can detail actually this body more. I'll go to the front view again. Select the sketch, go to sketch, and then go to circle and create myself here a circle 20 millimeters. This circle will be kind of like creating a depression. So when I hold the bottle, my thumb and my index finger can go into. So this has to intersect a little bit with the main body, like this. And then here where I have this intersecting with the bottle and cutting the groove, then there we can round the edges. So let's exit the sketch. I will select both sketch regions and then select this vertical line and do a revolve. I show the bottle now and select bottle and this part and then say subtract. I actually would like to keep all the parts, so the original building parts. And then when I hit done, I have a new piece. So there's the bottle. I call this one ring. Very good. And there you can see now how we cut this part out. Very good. These two edges I will select and round. For a detail of 5, this looks pretty good. So you can see now, you can imagine if you hold this, you can put your thumb and index finger like a ring around it. So this is kind of like a detail that is now horizontal. Can we do this vertically? So for this, I will rename this, let's say, bottle horizontal ring, and then hide this for the moment. Here's my raw part again. I will go to the bottom view, zoom in, and then click sketch. This will then create a new sketch right on the bottom. Also here, I will start with a circle, go to the grid, and then start sketching here a circle. We can make this 14 millimeters. We can see this is the base here. This is the side. And we take a look from the top. There we can see how much this will intersect. This is actually very good. And then I exit the sketch, select the sketch region, and start extruding this upwards. 145 millimeters. So what is actually really nice here already we can see is when it already starts cutting into the bottle. At the bottom, this is a little bit too early. So what I will do now is I click on this icon and then say new body. So it only creates this new body. It doesn't do any cutting yet. This has a radius of 40 millimeters. So we can fillet this with 7 and create a nice dome on top. Then this body we select and move away by 1 millimeter. If we want to be precise, we can also select the sketch and then move this accordingly. So if I go to the front view, now I can see where this starts intersecting. Very good. This, for example, we could call vertical groove. Now, this I would like to replicate 8 times, 10 times, 12 times around the bottle. This is very easy to do. With this groove selected, we go to the pattern, select circular, then the origin, I move on to the circular part of the bottle. You see it snaps right to the center. I can specify the quantity. And now I will just rotate this 360 degrees. And then I can see how many pieces we have. 8 actually looks very good. 10 was too much. 6 is not enough. So you see, it's very easy to visualize the quantity. Very good. Click done. Perfect. Now here I have this circular part. Here is my bottle. So from the bottle, I can now subtract these elements we created. So we've both selected the bottle and the folder. The folder, as you can see, selects all the parts. We hit subtract. Magenta plus is correct for the bottle and all the other parts minus. We also here again keep the original. Very good. I will, before we continue, select these two, so the bottle and the circular pattern folder, and put them into a new folder. And then this folder I will call building parts. This is kind of like a backup. So from these parts, I can always create more pieces. There is now the bottle with the result. And here, swipe to the left, bottle, vertical grooves. This actually looks very good. I would like to round these individual edges. So what I will do now is hide the sketch. Then with the pencil, press and hold. Swipe over to the left and hit edges. But I have to do this actually on top. Go down, select edges. There we are. And you see, that it selected also these horizontal parts. So you have to be careful if you go left or right. You see, when I now go from the right to the left side, it selects only these parts which the selection intersects with. And then I can give this a 2 millimeter fillet. And because all these cuts resulted into tangent lines and curves, it can fillet everything for me. So I do not have to select all the lines. Just basically from each cut, I only need to select, technically speaking, one line. But as I showed you here with the pencil, right side, go over to the left side, select edges. This then selects all the needed elements because they're all tangent. It fills in and then fillets everything. Perfect. Very nice. Very good. So now we have actually this cut and this cut. This is actually really nice. At this point, the bottle we could actually say is nearly done. And the only thing that is missing is actually the groove part, the threading. To do this, however, we should actually shell the design. The main reason is the shelling is a very complicated task, and the adding the threading to it is an additional piece we can do at the end. So to add the shelling now, I will select the top face and then select shell. We'll just give this a 2 millimeter material thickness. And then we do the same for the second part. There we are. If I go to the front view and lower right corner, turn on section cut, we can now see how beautifully everything was shelled, including all the external roundings of details we did. Perfect. Okay. So I would say that at this point, the bottle is done and we can actually now work on the cap.